We all love real estate, and we love to talk. You know what? The common term is real estate porn. Everybody likes to look at the houses of the rich and famous. But, you know, there is some real estate porn you don't even see. That's how bad it is. No, that's how good it is, I guess. I mean, the really ultra wealthy, the really coolest places you could live, don't come on the market. They're not an MLS. You're not going to be able to find them. It goes back to that old saying of they know who they are. And so does Royce Pinkwater, the founder of Pinkwater Select, which is perhaps one of the most exclusive real estate agencies in the world. I could put it that way. It's basically you work with the super prime property world. Can you define that? Is there a dollar figure, a location? Is there some way to put it in perspective for our listeners?
Well, Mike, we work in the top of the market. We work not only in terms of the finest residential property, but also the best commercial property opportunities. We have found over the last couple of years there is a new trend in the top buyer in the markets, which is that normally they would have, in order to diversify their holdings and to find safe havens for their money, they would have bought 10, 12, 5, 6 properties. We had one person that owned 29. And somewhere along the line, about 2 years ago, the ultra high net worth buyer said, hey, wait a minute, I don't need 10 homes. I could use 4, maybe. And I'd like the rest to be income producing property that's more commercial in scope. So that's when we started liaising with commercial experts and people who owned and wanted to sell their commercial properties as well.
Now, these are not necessarily the things that people live in or don't live in New York that we see in these 100-story ugly towers they've been building. These are things that you probably just won't see, right?
Well, you know, it's an interesting thing. At that price point, and even lower, when you ask me what price point we start in, we actually start in, you know, at $5 million and go all the way up to infinity. But when you're spending a certain amount of money for a certain type of product, you're making an investment. So as we know, a lot of the people that are buying are investing in these towers and have no intention of using them, which, you know, of course, it's unfortunate because we would like to see the towers and all of the
properties. It's interesting to see if the lights are even on once people start,
Right. That started years ago in London when Berkeley Square was, you know, primarily owned by the Middle East, and they never hardly ever came. So it was a dark square. And that impacts environments because of the goods and services that aren't supported, a variety of things. But in the meantime, we advise investors on the best places to put their money. Very often, as you said at the beginning of this, they are off-market property.
Is there a place that people like to go right now where you find these, or a kind of place? Is it, I mean, ranches out in the hinterlands, or is it just a really, really nice apartment in New York or London?
Well, it covers the gamut. It's very interesting. New York and London have been the top global markets for real estate property and investment for quite some time. Now, boom, here's Miami. Boom, LA is trending like no one would ever have imagined. And in LA, for example, they're not only building houses and huge houses, but now they're building luxury condominiums. The Four Seasons, for example, is doing a new condo project there. Ian Schrager is doing a new condo project there. People in LA never bought apartments before, but investors will buy apartments.
Well, we were talking a minute ago about who's selling. Who buys? I mean, are these hedge fund people? Are these, you know, long-term inherited wealth? Who's the buyer for these kinds of properties?
Well, it's an excellent question. We have found that the buyer is individuals. They mostly buy in LLCs, corporations. Occasionally, there are even syndicates, which we think is going to trend. Art is already being bought in syndicates, and we think property will be as well. The first very notable example of that in residential is Bill Ackman and a group of his investors buying a big floor at 157 and having it known that this was a syndicated buy. So we feel the Chinese, who are very accustomed to buying in syndicates for other things, are going to increasingly do that in the property world. And that will be, as you say, farms and ranches are very interesting. We have one in Dallas, right? Not in Dallas, but in Texas right now, that covers five counties. It's the biggest ranch. It's the number three biggest ranch in the whole world.
Well, we only have a few seconds left, but just for the fun of it, quickly tell me, what's the most expensive property you're listing right now?
Oh, gosh, it's probably $400 million.
Okay.
And it's in Monaco.
Oh, I was going to say that. I thought it was the state of Rhode Island, but
it's just a penthouse.
It's just a penthouse for $400 million. What was it that Fitzgerald said about the rich being different?
Well, they do have a lot of options.
And a lot of money. Royce Pinkwater, thank you very much for being with us from Pinkwater Select. You can get in touch with her if you got $400 million, I guess. Or if you have a nice small place worth that you want to sell. This is Bloomberg's Taking Stock. I'm